Leaving Uray behind, we're heading our way up Highway 550 to Grand Junction, Colorado, on our way to the Great Salt Lake. We're gonna make a quick pit stop there and then continue on to Twin Falls, Idaho.
Morning that I was wearing my headscarf, my head warmer for a hat.
Yeah.
I want to take my whole body, put it in that ice chest. We've been out of Wi-Fi for a while, and we just hit a town with Wi-Fi. We're sitting down, we're gonna have a good pizza for lunch, and we get a notice that our credit card.
Yeah, get a text all of a sudden, credit card's been compromised.
Someone went to Lego and charged a dollar.
Yeah.
Dollar.
They stopped it at a dollar.
Oh.
So they canceled that, and I got a new card coming, but so much fun.
Yeah.
I have no tolerance for thieves. None.
Well, we'll figure it out.
Yep. Laughing at me.
I'm sorry. It was just so funny because he was so spent yesterday, and we figured it out.
I wasn't spent when I got here. I was okay.
Yeah.
Our second night of sleeping in freezing temperatures. It wasn't easy for her either, okay?
I was afraid Richard was going to throw in the towel, but what I was left.
Wait, I never, always and never are two words you should always never use, and the word can't. That's not in my vocabulary.
Okay, so here's the other thing we wanted to show you. Is that pointed in the right direction?
Yeah. More stuff we don't need.
We've downsized again last night, and we stuffed my backpack. You know, we don't need this. We've got the Monster. We don't need our hiking sticks because we'll do some hiking on Glacier, but we're not like rock crawling or anything.
Yeah, we're not going and big time.
And the rest is clothes that we figured, okay, we've got the worst of the cold weather. We did it in the clothes that we have. So why do we need all these other warm weather clothes?
So what do you think? I don't need those.
What do you think this weighs?
I don't know. It's too much.
20 pounds?
20 pounds or better. Yeah.
All right.
We're going to strap it onto Chris's bike now so she can lug it around.
Oh my gosh. It's going to make me so top heavy.
It's not like you're flying into the corners anyways.
All right. So today we're going to try to go swim in the Great Salt Lake.
So we did some research, and we found out that the locals don't do this. Why, do you say? Because there's brine shrimp and flies.
Do the flies
doesn't
bite?
That sound attractive?
Do the flies bite?
I don't think they do, but okay. One of the descriptions was the flies parted ways as we walked into the water.
And didn't you also read something about the brine shrimp might crawl in your swimsuit?
I think that was somebody just freaking out. But it's way more saltier than the ocean. So you're supposed to be able to float, you know, like bobber. Like won't even get your hair wet. Can't get your hair wet.
So we'll let you know. We're going to Antelope State Park. Antelope Island State Park.
Yep. Here in Salt Lake City.
It's Sunday, so we're hoping that the traffic will be kind of cleared, parted for us.
In the town? Yes. Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
Otherwise, we wouldn't want to venture into Salt Lake.
See? Yeah, we would have gone around it. But we're going to go to, like Chris said, we're going to Antelope State Park, and we're going to do a bucket list item and just say we've been in the Salt Lake. Maybe it'll give healing properties.
If not, we'll let you know whether you should come here or not.
Yeah. We'll see about the brine shrimp and the flies.
All right.
Doesn't that sound good? I'm just excited.
You're
that
excited
it,
about
it
that?
Just sounds really, really yummy. Chris looks pretty good for being a biker chick, huh?
Yeah, that's me. Ooh.
I said my trailer feels 20 pounds lighter.
Thank you. Here, turn left. Just about a mile, you'll find some big parking lots. That's our beach access. Okay. Showers and restrooms right there in the parking lot.
About a quarter mile walk.
Shrimp, I thought they meant shrimp.
No, look all the little red spots you see in the water.
Now I can see why these could get in your bathing suit. I thought they were big shrimp.
No, they are. They're shrimp. They're little shrimpies.
Okay, so check this out.
Okay, ready? There you go. Just floating. Not even getting our heads wet. Just sitting here not doing anything. Without getting your head wet.
I know.
That's fascinating. I find that's fascinating.
It's really cool.
Yeah. So, I would suggest coming here to the Great Salt Lake.
If it's on your bucket list.
If it's on your bucket list.
Go for it.
Try to find a time. My guess is that if it's a little bit breezy like it is now, 9-10 mile an hour winds, that's a good thing. Because they say there's flies at the beach. And there is, but it's not. I can imagine it would be much more if there was no wind, for sure. For sure.
And it was only $3 a bike?
Yeah, $3 coming as a couple. It's supposed to be $6 a piece, but she was cool since we're together. She must have figured that out.
She gave us away.
Yeah.
The license plate.
Yep, bobbing in the Salt Lake, not even getting my head wet.
I know, this is great. This is just so cool. I never thought it would be like this.
Nope.
I mean, I've heard stories, but wow. Out here all day.
Yeah, you don't need a floaty. Don't even bother bringing a floaty. The hike back. Deep sand. It's a good workout.
When you're in Idaho, I don't know what to say now. I've always read about these things, so now I'm gonna try one. I'm so excited when I saw these in the grocery store. I don't know why.
Chocolate, marshmallow, and coconut.
Let's see. Oh my. What? You definitely can only eat one.
Interesting.
Very interesting.
Coconut, marshmallow, and chocolate.
I remember reading about these. These are like a long-standing tradition.
Well, I think that motorcycle riding is sometimes romanticized as being all bright sunshine and stunning views, when the reality of it is, a lot of times the weather doesn't cooperate with you, and there's always stuff in the road that wants to take you out. Hold on. Wow.
Little refrigerator.
This is kind of
So I noticed a new way, or an easy way to open up these, whatever you pronounce that, Hepshine.
Whatever.
Okay, so these are chairs, unlike the one I'm sitting in now. Okay, here's the cover. And then here's the magic part that I learned just yesterday. You ready for this?
Uh-huh.
You pull it out and rotate it around a few times.
Check that out. Put it over here.
Yeah. You see that?
That was pretty cool.
You see how easy it was? just rotate it.
You just rotate it. You don't have to beat yourself half to death like I've been doing with those stupid sticks.
We'll slip that over there. We'll set this in. And yes, these are 300-pound rated chairs.
Sweet.